Hello, everyone! Dustbunny here from Slackers Undercover, and I'm alive.
I'm alive!
You honestly don't know how happy I am to actually be here. The last 4 or 5 days have been nightmarish. The flu that was brought into this house was a trip and a half, and there were times I wasn't sure I was going to get through it, because it's... Whew. Oh, being dehydrated is not fun at all. But hello, everyone! Dustbunny, would you hear? This is Pocket Rogues. Let's do some Pocket Rogues. Let's actually record some Pocket Rogues. Because I actually have played Pocket Rogues when I was sick. Here and there. I couldn't look at screens for too much because it was just hurting my eyes and giving me a headache. But I got a little bit and played the archer because it was pretty chill to play and screw around with. Daily quest today, reach third floor of the location Barrel Mound, third floor of location Adamantite Garden, and kill 3 creatures of the human class, Humanoid. Think we got that covered. And the only things I leveled up off screen were damage, and I think I did through 1 onto archery range and 1 onto necromancy. I was trying to stay away from too much leveling up off screen, but I had coins and I had to spend them somewhere. I also just bought 1 of each of the things that we've seen already. Just because I want to know what these 3 items were. Alright, those are our quests. Check. Let's go. Archer is kind of out of hand. Admittedly, I know. Archer's a little bit crazy, but we're going to move over Archer. We're actually going to move down to Berserk. Or Hunter, excuse me. Hunter has points. Who played Hunter? Sweetheart, did you play Hunter? Okay. Hunter's been played. He's been touched. Well, you know, not... Let's not go there. Alright. Hunter's been played, but let's give Hunter a shot real quick, just so we can say we done tried it. Seems to be a melee-based... Kind of a melee range, in a way. Kind of like an assassin. See, Bloodsucker, not too powerful lunch. We change to absorb some health of the enemy when killing. We need to improve the blades haul in order to get any of these done, so... We're just highly limited at this, so invest in that. And I suppose that's that. So yes, Hunter it is. We'll see if we'll do... What are our quests again? What can we do? 3 creatures of humanoid class, if I remember right. The catacombs has goblins. And goblins are humanoid. Yeah, we have 13 out of 13. I was wondering, I was screwing around with the archer in this area, and I didn't realize I actually finished it because, well, as you can see, part of it's not finished yet. But that's cool. It's not really even, like, finished, because it was, like, 5 stages in, and, you know, it branches off to a new section. So, we have all these unlimited sections we can do now. Endless sections we can do now. Pardon. Yes, let's do catacombs. Starting here, we should really get through catacombs with the... This is the hunter? Yes, it is. Should be able to get through and kill some humanoids in the catacombs fairly easily. This is new. Oh yeah, I unlocked pockets. Quick pockets. Oh my gosh, I can click on the quick pockets. Oh, that is flippin' brilliant. And awesome. And brilliant and awesome. You know what I mean. Many things. Many degrees of awesome. You know how I originally said back in like episode 3, which was technically 2. I'm not sure how this game would have worked as a phone or a mobile game. I'm starting to see it a little bit more. It's not all too complicated, and you can point yourself in a general direction and just have at it. And if your skill, oh my gosh, these guys are kids just ganging up on me. Stop it. If your buffs are on a little touchpad right there, then, you know, I could see it. I really could see it. I was hoping for some Halloween content added in, because I noticed in the front, you guys get to see it, because it flew by so fast beginning, but the Pocket Rogues had a little jack-o'-lantern on their logo, and I was like, ooh, did we get some sort of Halloween bonus, or was that just letting them know of that's a pumpkin? It's very clearly a pumpkin. Okay, I may be answering my own question here. We'll see. We'll see soon.
Can we?
No! Leave me alone. I'm just a man exploring a sewer or something. Why am I here? Oh yeah, I have rage already.
Pew!
Are they just boxes? That's unfortunate. I wonder if there's any like loot or anything, or if there's just pumpkin boxes now. Wait, that's a candy. Very clearly a candy. Did it? It did.
What?
Oh, hold on. Oh, I just realized what I did. I didn't even do it intentionally. Intentionally? Intentionally. I didn't do it intentionally. I didn't do it intention. Post sickness, I'm still crazy. The 30% experience boost that we had up to November 1st is now over. Which means, had I not been sick yesterday and I could have recorded yesterday and played more of this game, we could have gotten that experience boost for 60 seconds on top of the 30% experience boost that we were normally getting pre-November 1st. But now we're not. Okay, that is an actual pumpkin that's trying to kill people. I take it back. Halloween has been added. It's a demon? A pumpkin demon? I approve. I thoroughly approve, my friend. Probably should actually equip some stuff. Because we need stuff. We actually have really fast mana regen. I'm impressed. Which makes me think that the hunter isn't so much as the right click is a power skill as much as it's just a basic skill at range. Yeah, because I mean, look, our left click drops it by 2, our right click drops it by 2. It is exactly that. The hunter is just both melee and range at the same time. I approve. I thoroughly approve. That looks like it hurts. Jambi. So you know how I said catacombs was for goblins? I may have been very wrong about that. Who's making that noise? Making too much noise. Stop it. I exploded that pumpkin with a poison trap. There's 4 more mobs, but we're bailing. Later. Lollipops. These are individual items.
What?
So, my question is, do these stack for one? Oh my gosh, they stack. It's great. Gosh, that's brilliant. Please don't kill me while I say things are brilliant, please. Hey, we actually got a weapon. We can survive now. Yeah, it's not the best weapon, but it's a weapon. A little bit of attack increase is better than no attack increase. Does it mean we can switch these out at any time? Yes, we can. Probably should switch out with meat. Might be more meat now. So how is everyone's days going? Or in this case, maybe evening? A little bit evening over here. It's later in the afternoon than I'd like to have started actually getting a chance to do this, but I'm like on the verge of overtaking the whole sickness thing, so it's still slow going. Like right now, and I know this is just everyone else is gonna be like, why is this a celebratory thing? Why are you celebrating this? This is the first cup of coffee I've had in like a week, man. A week! Do you know how big that is? I haven't had a coffee in a week. Hashtag coffee. Also hashtag not sponsored. But yeah, the... I love coffee. I not really so much the caffeine of it really doesn't do me anything anymore. I think over time I've actually just gotten over that. I've been so used to caffeine, the caffeine just doesn't faze me like that. I just enjoy the taste, I say. I mean, it's refreshing. That is a humanoid. What up, bro? He's dead now. We were just a little bit poisoned for some time. Coffee, getting over being sick, which is fantastic. You have no idea how great that is. Because this is the block of Fallout 76 betas, and let me tell you something. Trying to try out the beta when you're trying to hold your guts in is not a fun thing. So, beta day one, got to play for about an hour, and I was partially coherent. Wasn't fun. Beta day two for PC. Totally missed out because I was asleep. Thanks to meds. But beta day three, you will see both me and Mad Dog on here playing that. Enjoying and having fun together. The game intended. Maybe. Or maybe we'll just be killing people like crazy people. It's actually more of what I imagined. My kids will be there. I'm not gonna lie, I think I dig this game for two reasons. One, it's simplicity. It's advancement, because I like the whole Rogue Legacy, your offspring advances. But I like that it's chill enough that I can talk about other things while I'm playing it. I can put potions there now. Yo, give me some potion. Give me some of that potion there. In case of emergency, I got this. Oh gosh. Maybe I don't got this. Ooh, robe of heavenly protection. Should be, yes, protection against undead. That's absolutely perfect for this area. Okay, you know what? This works great. But the nice thing about being able to go into your menu to use it is it stops time. You're gonna have a chance to heal up without the worry of dying. As soon as I get my quest done, I'm a happy man. There we go. Extermination. Not really sure how the humanoids feel that quest is named Extermination. I can't be that happy. Come on. Die already. Not me. You got the wrong idea. Four left. Are we gonna do four left? No. So why is that? Don't put a torch as my main. Also, I can unlock more quick links, right? By upgrading Taylor more. Wait. I see a little one here. If my one key activates this, then what was his name? Open from Ethergaming. I suggest making that a little bit brighter, because I almost didn't catch that. Yes, one totally does. Please make the one brighter. Make it a different color if need be, because right there it just looks like a weird corner. Let out your guy. I thought I died for a second. In fact, I might have died for a second if the game was nice. Serrated dagger, hold up. Same exact thing I have. Yes. Iron dagger is 0.51, 30% speed. It's less damage, but yeah, it's not that. It's not that grand. Not grand at all. So really, there's no sense of me not being able to get through most of the stuff, at least for a good ways, because I mean, we started with nothing, one or two skill points, but that's walking in and killing three mobs and going, ooh, look, skill points. So, just continuing on, I mean, you have a ranged attack and you have a melee attack. The fact that you have a ranged attack makes you almost as good, if not as good as the archer, and that really is his strong point. Movement speed, attack speed. Ranged attacks. Of course, then one would wonder why it isn't the wizard and necromancer as level up as the archer. Well, the archer fires like a machine gun. At some point, I actually need to use this middle. That's a forward roll. So that's the opposite of what the archer has. Archer has a little like backward jump. I can dig it. And that's all the mobs. That's everybody on this floor. Let's head out. Oh yeah, we've got a guy we can hire that will die instantly because they're pretty bad. Question mark though. Since we have these guys finished, should we kill them off to do the other? Yeah, it'll be lame because I mean the other daily strikes are really easily completed. Third floor van, I think, already. Making it to the third floor is pretty easy. Easy peasy. Oh, hi. Probably should get right in your face. I know you guys are saying use the lollipop, but it's only for 35 seconds. So let's get the big boss down to about as low as I can and then pop it, and then we make sure we get full experience boost out of that. Okay, we better finish this. Actually, do I have... Yes, I do have some HP time. Okay, now that we got that down, let's eat this for the experience, boys. Finish him off, get the experience, yeah! And all the loot. Now we just run laps here and get our victory steps. Which isn't really anything important, but I want the least of the chests. We got Serrated Blade and a Halberd. Hold up. 3.0. We lose 2% crit, but we gain 3 damage. Yo, that's a lot of damage. In the grand scheme of things. Yeah, I think we'll just keep pushing, honestly. See how far we can take this boy. Combat dagger. Yeah, no, it's 0.5. Yeah, you know what? It's a 0.5. Now, the 3 is huge. 0.5, but we gain 10% speed and gain one crit. I wonder if that's actually worthwhile. 3.62. It's same tier because it's the 168 price range. You know what? For the attack speed increase and the crit... Let's try out Halberd for now. Because it doesn't seem like it affects our range speed by too much. Alright, let's bail. Blow this joint. Okay, well here's where I was getting confused earlier. Abandoned in prison. That's the one with a whole lot of goblins. Oh, look at all them goblins. Hey, goblins. Okay. Hits them like a truck. Okay, they have range. Let's run. Yeah, we do not do archer damage, that's for sure. Attack this guy. So, melee attack is definitely stronger than our ranged attack, but puts us more in harm's way too, so it's like not as great. Oh, I just realized it's serrated blade, serrated dagger, 3-4, 2-1-2. Ew, okay, we actually had a weapon upgrade the entire time, I did not know it. Oops. For now, in case we die, because they're way more valuable than just blowing them up and trying to get some parts out of them. Yeah, our melee attack is much slower at this larger weapon. So, thank you. Why didn't I pick that up earlier? Poisoned rat, how did I shoot you in the back? Question not the fates, question not. So one thing I am noticing, well, it seems to work on this guy too, so the ranged attack does act as a shield breaker even for this guy, even though that's kind of one of his main attacks. Yeah, it's really useful, these shield guys. Honestly, should have hung on to that one. Because I don't think we vastly need the HP increase at this very moment. I was going to toss down. Let's do my struggle potions right here and then use a meat to clear inventory. I have so many things in my butt right now. Do I look bigger to you? It's just the armor. Excuse me? Yeah, dance around the mage caster. You look dangerous, sir. Yeah, you look a little dangerous. I'm gonna just step this way. Oh yeah, he one-shot that crap. I can't even do that. Oh, I can. You're not so dangerous after all. Punch you, my friend. Oh, he did. Oh, okay.
Yeah, here, just a little bit.
21 of my HP. Of course, I think he hit 21 of my HP. My HP. 21 of my HP as soon as my HP buff wore off, which is unfortunate and funny at the same time. It's kind of scary. A little bit scary. It's like when you're driving, you turn a corner and you're just like, hey, I'm just gonna speed just for a second, because there's never any cops down this road. And as you start doing that, you notice there's like two cops just sitting there. You're like, almost did something really stupid there. Ooh, man, that is a pile of cash. Pile of cash. You know, part of me actually feels bad about this. I have to have those delusions of grandeur when it's like, I'd be able to do this very easily, IRL. You know, be an adventurer and fight for gold, but at a certain point, you're going to be fighting creatures of intelligence, and even though goblins seem very savage in nature, they are intelligent creatures, so essentially, you're hunting down little people at that point. Can you not lose your mind? That's gonna be his goal. Tell by his big nuts. Sweet motherload. Those actually, like, I mean, okay, that's not special, but geez, 10 defense. 20. I don't know how that increases my view, considering it covers my nose and it gives me little, like, it's a magneto helm. Whatever, we'll just go with. If that's what you believe you are, then so be it. Believe that you are all you can be, my friend. I don't think I can be that cold and merciless, of course. Of course, in DayZ, I have shot companions so that I may live. Essentially pulling a Shane on people. I'll admit it. You know, I gotta be faster than the zombies. You just gotta be faster than your friends. Okay, same thing we got on the other one. The other one has better defense on it, so I'll hang on that just for the money for now, even though it's only $47. Let's just yoink that too. Yoink. Forgot to heal. Eh, it's okay. We were pretty much caught up. Plain old cloak. Are we full? No, we're not full. The game's just weird. Fine, toss this then, since the cloak didn't want to hang out with the shirt. Oh, this may be our death here. We haven't really been getting stronger Are you coming this way? Are you special? Oh no, you are much faster when you're angry. This one's only level 4. If we get one actually caught up to the level range of the area we're in, we're probably SOL. That guy's gonna taint you. And fast, and just an HP sponge. He could probably one-shot us, honestly. I know the green ones of his kind can do about 40 damage, and... well, not half that much damage. And at our best. Let's get a couple good strikes in. Thank you. Not giving me any good stuff here. I still really need an off weapon. Please! I beg you! Yeah, this isn't an off weapon, right? No, that is clearly not an off weapon. So no, we have not picked up any off weapons. Which doesn't sound like much, but you know, considering... considering we're fighting over the idea of what's better, 1 to 2 damage increase over weapons, at this point in abandoned prison, we should be getting a weapon, an offhand that gives us up to +4 if we're to damage. I don't know if hunters get a damage boost or not. Probably a quiver or an arrow or something. But even then, if not, defense increase would be nice, evasion increase would be nice. Anything increase would be nice. That's pretty much how I'll take it. Anything increase. Pumpkin! Oh, that pumpkin got destroyed. Can we, please hit the guy who's in front of me? Thank you. Can we get meat? Nothing. Still nothing. Still nothing. And only 4 left in the zone. My word. Ha! 4 left in the zone. Oh. 3 left in the zone. 2 left. This is the goal. I don't really want him to touch me. I feel like his melee is... I feel like he's essentially a hunter at this point. And his melee is probably way stronger than his range. Kind of like that. Stuff. I don't know what that is right there. That might be something I need, but let's get through. Let's go here. Battle the daggers here. I have faster mana regen than a warlock. Don't question me, it's just the way life is. We're just gonna... we're worth $168. It's hard to say no to that. Tosses out of my hand though. It does 10 damage. We can do 10 damage in a really short amount of time too. You know what? An item sword would be nice too. To put all my potions and stuff up top or down below. Yeah, I'm nitpicking. I'm probably nitpicking at this point. Oh, it's just an iron dagger. For the daggers, that's a weapon replacement, yeah? Yes, it is. We can learn what your offhand is, boy. Antidote, come here. I may need you in the future. Excuse me? Okay, you're horrifying. Must be a Halloween enemy, a nightmare. Just dropped normal candy, 15% experience increase for 60 seconds. Actually, let's go ahead and pop that, because I feel like we're going to be dying soon. Wandering troll level 10, yeah, he's gonna hurt if he hits us. Oh my gosh. Yeah, no, that hurt, that definitely hurt. Seriously. Experience. Gold. Teresa. What is chunking me for as bad as the chunking me? I think it was just too much junk. Too many things on me at the same time.
Ooh,
right. That's a big, bad wizard person. Oh my gosh, he does 11 damage. Oh, he does 11 damage a hit. Crossbow bolt. Hold on, you must be my offhand. I am very pleased. 126 coins. My gosh. Hang on to you. Are you my offhand damage? Damage one! Oh, baby! Look, it's plus one hold damage. That's awesome. How that works into normal equations, I have no idea, but it makes me feel fancy. That's half the battle, right? It makes me feel like I know what I'm doing, what I'm talking about. Dear, help me out here, please. Let me out of my... Is he attacking with a pumpkin? Is that just a pumpkin dancing with that man? I almost don't want to interrupt him. Obviously. Having a good time. Tanto, 1 to 4. Yeah, we're in the, like, 2 to 6 range. Yeah, 3 to 6 range. We don't need your Tanto business. No. I'm sorry, pumpkin. Four left, really. Not today, buckos. In fact, it's one crit better, but super slower than a halberd. In fact, I'm kind of reluctant to see the goodness in this at all. I'm just gonna get rid of that now. Since we've confirmed that crossbow bolts are our offhand, then there's really no reason to have anything else. What in the world am I looking at over there? Okay, so those are not the Wandering Trolls. Those are upgraded versions, at least greens, if not golds. Okay, let's not deal with those guys just yet. Give me a free hand, but... Ooh, buddy. Oh, poop. Oh, poop. Oh, double poop. Yep, we got poops. I really need some healing items. Also, I don't like how you guys are doing, like, taking 1.6 damage per block. Yeah. Yeah, we're starting to reach that point where our weapons and our abilities are slowly getting trumped by everything around us. Oh no! We killed the big one as we died. But you know what? I think for essentially an unskilled hunter, I think we did pretty well. Yeah, that 10 skill points for Hunter, 10 level ups, that 30% pre-November 1st experience gain, very noticeable now that it's gone. Because we would have had like 16, 17, 18 easily. Get our 6 gems out of that. Alright, we've got 6846 coins to spend. Well, rule of thumb is... if you earn it on a character, you can only spend it on that character as its haul. So we were on Hunter, so we can level up Hunter. I think Hunter's pretty fun. It's nice to have the choice between a range and a melee attack, and I'd like to see like the one blade skill that we can get called Bloodsucker that does healing on melee attack. That could be fun, but the problem with melee, again, is... the amount of damage you're taking versus the amount of damage you're dishing out is awkwardly high, so... or we can get a traveling merchant. In a camp, you can find a traveling merchant who will buy unnecessary things from you. As the buildings improve, the chance to get to the camp increases, and after level 3, you can sell not only unused items, but also equipment. That means we could get full value off of items that... normally we break down for just pittance, which is, you know, that just for cents on the dollar. If it's worth $100, we can break it down for like $5. It's only a 3% chance, but it gets us started at least. You know what? I think the blade, the hunter. I think hunter deserves a couple levels up. Next time, if I screw around or if I just play on here for recording, we'll definitely get this one. Because 6,000 shouldn't be too hard, especially with an archer roll or something. And that's something we need. We really do. Because it's just going to result in more money gain. More money gain is going to result in more expansions. I mean, isn't that the secret to it? Advance the things that are going to make you advance faster. These two, they're expensive, but they result in more money, so that's why they're expensive. Yeah, 15,000 to get 10% up to the price of each item. That's a lot of money. But let's actually get 2 or 3 levels in here. Yep, 2 levels, giving us 2346. Maybe hang on to that for now. Because I don't think there's anything in here. Yeah, well, okay. Yeah, we'll increase HP. Why not? Give our boys their much deserved skill points. Now, real quick, I did learn something interesting. I was wondering, how did pets level up? Now, there's no pet I have that has points. I do. You're wondering, like, wow, Archer has a lot of... the dog leveled up big time. Well, so every time you put points in over here, it's using your skill points for your character that you earned. Now, these over here aren't the number of points you put into it. These are actually the cost of how many skill points it is to level up another rank. I realized that after the fact, after I spent way too many points into this creature. So, for instance, spending 1 point goes to you require spending two. Spending 2 points requires spending four. Spending 4 points requires... it goes up from there. So this one's 9, so I've spent way too much HP. But at least we know now that the pets really don't level up, but you level up, and that lets your pets level up. So now we unlock some blade halls. We can get the Bloodsucker. That sounds great. Execution, a powerful attack on the White Spring, which has increased chance of causing critical damage to the target, whose health is less than 30%. So that's an execution skill, essentially, if you're from the Elder Scrolls series, too. You can have one that shoots a slow shot, releasing a lot of shells. That sounds cool. Spider Bolt, range attack with reduced damage, having the chance to slow down the enemy. That could be useful. Fan of Knives, the hunter sways a lot of knives in all directions around him. So damage and probably an escape a little bit. And the Sign of Sacrifice, hunter marks all nearby enemies, reducing their defense for 10 seconds to stop their regeneration down. That's like having our own personal torch without needing to carry a torch with us. That could be fun just because we could, well, save on our torch inventory, of course. I want to try Execution. That sounds fantastic. Spider Bolt intrigues me, but I like the idea of shooting multiple shells. Yeah, 4%, 2 arrows. Seems like as we upgrade it, the more arrows you get. I mean, even the image shows 3. Sigil of Sacrifices are a fan of blades. I don't really use the middle mouse button, but Sigil of Sacrifice sounds like something I would use. Let's try that out. That gives us 8 skills. 8 skills. We did get a lot of crystals with him, so let's invest in a creature for him. All these guys so far that I've run into seem to die fairly fast. The only one that doesn't die the fastest is the Golem, because it starts with 60 HP. It does more damage, the attack speed's lower, but survivability is huge in this game. If you're not going to survive, then there's no point. I'm going to throw one of our points into his HP that gives him 64. See, as you can see, that goes from 1 to 2, so 2 points in will be another percent gain for him, but out of the 2 more for us. I may do that. Yeah, so 14% gives him 68%. 68.4, that's good. That should be solid. Since we rely on the range more, this should be 2 and then 3. And 3, there we go. So we've used all his points. He's good to go. I think for just starting gear. Now, I learned this on the Archer. I don't know if I've recorded since I've learned this. The starting gear gets these durability points, and once they're gone, they're gone. However, you do get them for that many times of respawning on that one character, starting over on that one character. So it is useful. I don't think buying anything too frivolous is worthwhile for now. But things that are harder to find, like crossbow bolt, for whatever reason is hard to find for our character, and an iron dagger, just starting stuff is nice. Because you never know how long it's going to be before you find an iron dagger, something basic, or like a crossbow bolt. Let's not get into that situation again. We found a crossbow bolt like 2 floors before we died. So, yeah. We got it now. We recovered for 5 times of playing the Hunter. It'll be a while. So, next time, we're going to be hitting up the Berserker. What do we have to expect here? Mint Street Strike has a chance to slow the enemy down for a while, plus, pretty good damage. He has his own rage skill. That's cool. And his special is Whirlwind of Death. He has a whirlwind. He has a spin to win. That's great. In fact, let's go ahead and give him a pet too. We got We got the stuff. Let's go. Have we unlocked? Like, I don't think we've unlocked any equipment for him yet. Oh, well, technically we have. Should we just start him up? Just ready to rock and roll? Why not? He doesn't have an offhand. Oh! I guess that makes sense. Because he's all power, nothing else. That's an interesting hat. Why is it purple? We haven't seen it before. It doesn't have a name. It doesn't have a name! I kind of want to buy it just because it doesn't have a name, and why do we have a recipe for it? We'll buy it. I don't know what hat that is. But we have it now. So thank everyone for joining me. Thanks for hanging out for more news and information on what's going on and what may be. Check out the description below if you like what you saw. Want to see more, like, slap the like button, bash the subscribe button, and share the video. This is Dustbunny Avenger. This is Pocket Rogues. I forgot the name for a split second because I'm dyslexic and blur. This is Pocket Rogues from Ethergaming. And I will talk to you folks later. Later on the ground. Bye.